In this example, we're given information about a Rankine cycle, and we want to calculate for each of the processes either the work or the heat. And so I show a representation of a Rankine cycle with numbers indicating places where we want to determine enthalpy so we can calculate these values. And so let me pause first and draw a log pressure versus enthalpy diagram to help represent where we are, and it makes it easier to visualize what we're trying to do. So this is the phase envelope, and I'm going to draw this step. This is the exit from the condenser. So this is 5. The pump, as we increase the pressure, the enthalpy changes very slightly. That's 1. Now at constant pressure, we go through the boiler, and the exit from the boiler is 3. We could call this point 2, but we're not going to need it. And then the enthalpy decreases, so let's indicate the direction we're traveling. And we're given this pressure, and we're given this pressure, and we're going to use the steam tables to find these enthalpy values. So first let's find this. We given 500 degrees C, 19.8 bar. So it's superheated steam, and we can look up in the steam tables. So you'll note I've also listed the entropy because S3 is going to be equal to S4 because this turbine is reversible. And so S4, 7.44 joules per kilogram Kelvin, is going to be, see from the diagram, indeed when we look at the steam table, it's going to be a combination of saturated liquid and saturated vapor. So X is the quality, the fraction that's vapor, times the saturation value S4, that would be the value here, plus 1 minus X then is a fraction of liquid and entropy here of liquid. So I'm going to look those values up and add them from the steam table. So I've substituted the values in, and then I can just solve this simple equation for X. And so this says 90.5% of the material leaving the turbine as vapor. And 1 minus X is the fraction that's liquid, 0.095. Well, now that I know the fraction of vapor, that this is 0.4, I should have labeled that. I should be able to determine H4, because H4 is calculated the same way as S4. Enthalpy of 0.4 is the fraction that's vapor times the enthalpy for saturated vapor, and then the fraction that's liquid, for that saturated liquid. So again, let me look these values up in the steam tables. At saturation conditions at 0.10 bar, and that happens to correspond to 46 degrees C. So I've now calculated H4, and we've also essentially have H5, because H5 is just saturated liquid, 46 degrees, that's the value here. So now H1 is the only enthalpy value I haven't calculated yet, and then we can start calculating work and heat. And so we need to do an energy balance. This is a liquid pump. And so the energy balance flow system is that delta H, which in this case is H1, the final, minus H5, the initial, is equal to the work of that pump. Because it's a liquid pump, turns out, and we won't show why here, but shown elsewhere, that's equal to the volume of the water times the pressure difference. It's going to be not a large number, but let's calculate that out. So the work of the pump, the volume, and the pressure difference, the pressure at 1 and across the boiler, that's 19.8 minus pressure condenser 0.1, and that's in units of bar. Well, we're going to have to convert this, so let me multiply it out and then add in the conversion factors to put it in units of kilojoules. So I calculate the pump work, and I guess I should add in here that I also use 1 kilojoule is 10 to the third joules to get this value. And I would write this as 2 kilojoules per kilogram in terms of significant figures. So we've calculated the work for the pump. We have H5, so I can now go back to this equation. Okay, so we can see that H1 is going to be H5 plus the pump work. I'll substitute those numbers in. Okay, so now I have H1. Now I should be able to do the balances on the other parts of the system. So let's look at the boiler. Energy balance there is delta H is Q. There's no work done, and that's Q heat, Q added. Delta H, if we look at our figure, H3 minus H1. So H3 minus H1 is equal to QH. Well, we've determined here both H3 and H1, so let me substitute those values. And here's the heat added to the boiler. I've reduced it to just 2 significant figures just because that's what's given in the original problem statement. So now we have the heat added to the boiler. Next, let's calculate the turbine. Again, the energy balance is, so the turbine, energy balance is delta H equals W. It's adiabatic turbine. H through the turbine is H4 minus H3. This is a reversible turbine. Since it was reversible, we can say that the entropy in equals the entropy out, and that's how we calculate the values here. So H4 minus H3 is going to be the work for the turbine. And let me substitute those numbers in since we've already determined them. So again, I've made the final answer 2 significant figures. Notice the negative sign. This is as we expect because we're taking energy out of the turbine as work, and so therefore the work term is negative. Well, we have one more unit, and that's the condenser. And energy balance, again, condenser. Delta H is equal to Q cold, and delta H is H5 minus H4. So H5 minus H4 is Q cold. Again, I'll pause and put in the numbers. So I'm reporting QC, and I should be a little more careful. That's a negative sign, and it should be negative because we're removing energy from the exit material from the turbine that enters the condenser. Condenser removing heat, that makes the sign negative. So the last thing it wants us to calculate is efficiency. Efficiency is the net work, absolute value, divided by the Q added, QH. And the net work is going to be the work of the pump plus work of the turbine, and the signs of those matter, over QH. So let me substitute in those values.